Hey, welcome to UK Wellcrafts. These are fairy ring champignons, a very common edible mushroom. They have a long growing season from around May through to October, but I find September is usually the best month for them. They're found in grasslands and lawns, often in fairy rings or partial rings, which you can see as a darker circle of grass like we have here. But there are many mushrooms that grow in fairy rings, like the fool's funnel, which can be deadly poisonous. So you need to be 100% sure of your ID before consuming. I'll do a video on fool's funnel next time I see them. We've had quite a bit of heavy rain here in the last few weeks, so there's lots of these mushrooms popping up now. Fairy ring champignons grow up to around 5 centimeters across the cap. The cap starts off convex, but flattens with age, and has a broad umbo or bump in the center of the cap. They're variable in color from light brown to a yellowish cream. The gills start off white and become a light yellowish color with age, and the gills are distant. And very importantly, the gills are free of the stem, so they're not attached to the stem. That's one of the main differences to the fool's funnel, which has gills that are decurrent, or gills that run slightly down the stem. And as I said before, the fool's funnel is deadly poisonous, so you need to check this on every mushroom. Doing a spore print doesn't help too much with these mushrooms because both fairy ring champignons and fool's funnel have a white spore print. The stems are generally around 5 centimeters tall. They're white to light brown and they are very tough. I don't usually eat the stems, or I just add them into my stock pot. The younger mushrooms are the best to eat before the caps have flattened out. They have a nice, firm, almost meaty texture. Fairy ring champignons have a good, savoury umami flavour that is perfect for soups. Sometimes I make mushroom pâté with them, or I pickle them. Here's a nice example of some fairy rings. You might be able to just make out a darker ring of grass there. If you look in that ring, you'll find lots of these fairy ring mushrooms. And the same over here, you can see the darker patches of grass there. And there's loads of mushrooms in amongst there. So it can be a really good way of spotting mushrooms from a distance when you notice these darker rings in the grass. And these rings do get quite a lot bigger than this.